The demo performed two separate actions, selecting the object clicked on, and if any object was found, then the object itself was modified and the point clicked on was highlighted. Picking objects on the screen with the mouse is quite simple in 3JS. Here's the first half of the mouse down function, which sets up to perform picking. The bulk of the code fires a ray from the eye into the world. This is a common way to perform picking. WebGL itself is focused on rendering, so has no real support for picking and other forms of interaction. It's up to the program to figure this out. To form a ray from the eye through the screen, we need two points. One's the eye's position in world space. That's easy. The other is formed using a point on the screen, that point being located wherever the user clicked the mouse. What we want to know is this point's location in world space. To do so, we need to travel upstream, back along the chain of transformations. Window coordinates to normalized device coordinates to view to world coordinates. Happily, 3JS makes this easy. How many times have I said that sentence during this course? The 2D point from the mouse down event is a document object model screen coordinate. This is like a WebGL window coordinate, only y equals 0 is at the top edge of the screen instead of the bottom. The mouse vector code here converts from this screen coordinate system into normalized device coordinates, which go from negative 1 to 1 in x and y. The z value doesn't really matter. Any value from z equals negative 1 to 1 will form a point on the ray. We next create a projector object. Really, it's better to create this object once during initialization and reuse it here, but I wanted to show the code all in one piece. The final line of code does the heavy lifting. It takes the NDC coordinate and forms a raycaster object from it. Raycasting is like ray tracing, except you only trace rays from the eye into the scene and no further. No new rays are spawned from intersections. Once we have this raycaster object, we can perform picking, also called hit testing. It's one line of code to pick. You feed a list of objects into the raycaster and it returns an array of intersections. The if statement checks if the ray has anything in it. If it does, then one or more intersections have been detected. These intersections are sorted front to back, so the first intersection on the list is the closest, which is usually the one we want. This first intersection has information about what the ray hit, including the object, face, and the face's index in the object. We use the object parameter in the next line to change the material to a random color. The intersects record also includes the distance and the point in world space. To show where the object was hit, we add a small sphere to the scene using this intersection point for its location. These are just examples. You can do whatever you like with the intersection information you get back.